happy Sunday or happy day after Record Store Day 2021. We're going to talk about Record Store Day. Hopefully, you are all able to participate in some format or another. I know some folks don't like the crowds, don't like the commercialism, I don't know, behind it. But I went out early, picked up a few goodies, so we're going to talk about them. Okay, actually, this first list here in June. Hey, let's back up. My name's Darren. Welcome to the Record Room. This is where I listen to music, talk about records. Pretty simple. Anyway, if you like what you hear here and what you see here, go ahead and subscribe, leave a comment, hit the notification bell, whatever you want to do. You guys know the story, what to do. So, anyway, I had a few things I wanted to pick up here on Record Store Day. The list was kind of meh for me. But there were a few things that I absolutely wanted, and luckily I was able to pick up everything I had on my list. Let's start out right off the bat. Prince, The Truth. Now I know there was quite a few copies of this available, but in my store that I went to, the first one in Champaign, Illinois, didn't have it. So I actually picked this up later in the afternoon at another store that had one copy left. So excited about this. If you don't know, this has never been released. It was part of an extra disc in, what was the name of the album? I can't remember one of the albums, but this is all acoustic. I haven't had a chance to listen to it, but I'm a big Prince fan, and this one is wasn't top of the list, but second to... if I could find it, I was definitely going to get it. This was top of the list. Quiet Kenny, right there. Kenny Dorham on this craft recording. Mono edition, Record Store Day edition. If you haven't heard this record, it's great. It's fantastic. It sounds good. I had a conversation with a guy last night. His was kind of so-so in terms of the quality. Mine was perfect. Just sounded great. So... this was absolutely what I wanted to pick up for Record Store Day, so I was glad to find it. I got up early to make sure I got into my local shop, and I got the last one. So sorry to that dude behind me. I know you wanted it. Hopefully you found one someplace else, but great record. This is another one that was high on the list, and this is from the Timeless series, and it says here, the Timeless series, it was the name of a concert that was created in homage to the composer arrangers who have influenced hip-hop in the most literal and profound ways. Mulatto Astatke from Ethiopia. If you've watched my channel, you know Ethiopian jazz is one of my favorite genres. And I have not listened to this yet. I kind of wanted it to be a surprise, so I'm looking forward to it. But it's from a live concert, live show, 2009. Usually just funky, creative, a lot of soul, a lot of course, you know, kind of African rhythm beats to Mulatu's music, and I'm sure it's going to be great. So I may do another specific video on that record alone. This was my impulse buy, The Police Live, 1983, Volume 2 from Atlanta. Huge Police fan. The first shop I went to, I said, didn't have Prince. So I was still early in the line. I'm like, well, what else? This was next. I love Police. Haven't listened to this yet, but it's on red vinyl. And, this is there was 83, and I think the other one was from the 70s. But this, so many hits on here from that era of Police. I love almost everything they do, so glad to have this one as well. So those are my Record Store Day pickups, but I did have a couple other things I wanted to talk about. Some other pickups that I got this week, believe it or not. on Record Store Day, I picked up some things outside of that. One, right here, Machine Gun Kelly, Tickets to My Downfall. My son, college-age dude, Luke, he turned me on Machine Gun Kelly. I'm like, yeah, really? Probably not my thing, but oh my, I love this album. This kid's really talented. It's not for kids, it's not for your youngins in terms of some of the language in this. It's a little dark, you know, it's a little gloomy, but it's pop punk, extremely catchy. Travis Barker's on the drums, and just kills it on this record. But it's a lot of hits you may have heard on the radio, that type of thing. But this is a gorgeous pressing, pink vinyl. It's one of the Walmart editions. I really haven't dug into Walmart stuff yet, so it's one of the first things I got. So really happy to have Tickets to My Downfall. If you haven't tried it, I'd say give it a shot. I think you might like it. And here, this right here, might be my favorite record I've bought so far this year. This is Cooley Patterson and Jason Isbell live at the Shoals Theater, June 15th, 2014. If you know about these three songwriters, they used to all be in the band Drive-By Truckers. Jason Isbell left the band, years ago to go on a solo career. And I don't think it was a great departure. I think there was some infighting and glad to see them get back together for a benefit concert in 2014. So three dudes sitting on stage with their guitars, amazing songwriters. A lot of the hits from some of their older stuff, from the Decoration Day record, from Dirty South, and some of Isbell's solo stuff. And this is a four disc set, red and blue vinyl. It was like $49. I mean, for what you get here, and it sounds really good for a live recording. I guess there was a lot of talking and banter. There was a recording online you could listen to this. Excuse me. And that wasn't included in here, so it'd be kind of nice to hear that. But boy, if you're into the alt country stuff, if you like the Truckers, if you like Jason Isbell, man, this is worth every penny of it. Sounds great. So much passion and emotion in these songs. And it's not perfect. I mean, you can hear some of the mistakes they make, which I think that makes it even more interesting to listen to. So excited about that. All right, that's it, guys. Hope you have a great day. Again, like, subscribe, hit the bell, that type of thing. Tell a friend. Looking forward to some more videos coming up. Hope you all had an amazing record store day. God bless, and we'll see you on the next one.